Oscillating fans like this are cheap, but they're kind of wimpy. So I thought, what if I make a fan blade to go on a 1 horsepower motor? More of an airplane style propeller, about this long, but I figure the motor probably won't spin that to full speed because it's too long, and then I'll just shorten it until it gets up to speed. Well, that is way out of balance, so I have to take quite a bit off of this side to balance it. It was about 8 years ago that this motor one time went flying on me, so this time I gotta make sure it's screwed down. All right, ready for the first spin up.
Well, I just blew the breaker.
Actually, I just heard this thing click. It was only the breaker on the power bar, so I'll just have to plug it in directly. Okay, this time I really blew the breaker. It was reading about 3,000 watts. And the reason the motor was revving up and down all the time is because the starter capacitor and starting circuit got it kind of close to speed. And as soon as that kicked off, the motor didn't have enough torque to maintain that speed. So I need to shorten these blades a little bit. And the amount of power this blade needs at a given RPM is proportional to its length cubed. So I'm only going to take off a little bit.
Kilowatts. 1.6. 1.4 kilowatts. I think I'll leave it at that.
All right, what is the wind speed? All right, that was a max of 18 meters per second, or 66 kilometers an hour, or 41 miles. Now, my fan versus a conventional fan. I wonder if I can make this spin backwards.
It did spin backwards.
I was a bit surprised by the thrust of that thing. Switching that motor by plugging it into a cheap extension cord was maybe not the best idea. So I just switched it by plugging it into the wall. It is hard to use, not because it's heavy, but because it's just got too much thrust that you have to push against. Works great on a driveway. I don't even have to get near the leaves.